you have ever been to Uganda, you know what a beautiful country it is, with its rolling lush hills, expansive Lake Victoria, and its distinctive red soil. But what is most stunning about the country is its people. They are so warm and they offer incredible hospitality and joy. We have so many good friends in Uganda. Every time we send a team over, we hear similar stories all centering around the people. They are caring and full of joy, ready to invite you into their lives. The last team and our only short-term outreach team for 2020 went in February and returned just as things were starting to lock down. They had an incredible time and were able to witness firsthand the people and the great work going on. We have been partnering with International Needs in Uganda since 2008. As an organization, they seek to transform the community around them through community development, evangelism and church planting, and recognize education as a key element in doing so. With our eyes solely on education the past few years, we have concentrated our support on the Bukwe Senior Secondary School, which includes grades 7 to 12. It is not a fancy city school, and yet it has been slowly making a name for itself. More and more students are getting recognized for their national exam results. They now compete with those fancy city schools, and they graciously give us credit for helping them gain that ground as we funded the building of their science lab back in 2013. This lab allows students to go beyond just the theory of science and into practical applications, a necessary step for preparing for university. Last year, we were honored to be in attendance to celebrate the grand opening of the girls' dormitory. Having a dorm allows students to stay on campus, giving them the best foot forward in education. Prior to the new dorm being built, girls were living in two of the classrooms, which was taking up essential teaching space. It also meant the girls were living in less than ideal housing. Since the dorm has opened, the girls have been thrilled. An additional win has been that the dorm raises the profile of the school and continues to draw in more students. And this really benefits the school greatly, as many of the students that attend are sponsored children. They get a subsidy directly from the school. As more students come in from the outside of the IN family, more income is brought in to support the school. Now this year, we are seeking to meet our commitment to International Needs so they can complete the boys' dorm, which is also highly anticipated and greatly needed. Boys in the area walk long distances to school, often arriving late for class. In the process of commuting back and forth, they can be pulled in many directions with family needs, peer pressure, and the tantalizing draw to quick money, instead of taking the long view and sticking with their education. Some of the boys currently live in a small, cramped building on campus, which poses sanitary and hygiene issues and lacks proper security features. The new boys' dorm, like the girls' dorm, will have capacity for 200 students, plus electricity and a separate block with showers, toilets, and laundry facilities. Being a resident on campus allows the students to focus on their studies, avoid risky lifestyles, and develop spiritually. Construction began earlier this year thanks to your generous gifts from last year's Christmas Compassion campaign. The groundbreaking in February was a huge community affair. Hundreds of students, parents, staff, and board members were in attendance and even participated with the initial digging. Since then, great progress has been made. In fact, due to COVID, the construction team was invited to go through the lockdown together on campus, meaning their work not only was on schedule, but actually went ahead of schedule. To date, the core building is completed, but there's much to be done for the students to move in. Wiring, plastering, painting, flooring, furnishing and fencing, as well as building the latrine blocks. Now, during COVID, there have been a number of unexpected blessings. One for sure is that the construction has gone ahead of schedule. Another has been the spaciousness of the girls' dorm during this season of social distancing. Long before anyone could have seen what was coming, God knew. Some students have been able to return to campus, but only those that are preparing for national exams. The new girls' dorm has allowed more than enough space for social distancing, and having running water in the latrine blocks has really helped with hand washing. As soon as the boys' dorm is open, it will also provide the same benefits. With your support, we will be able to keep our commitment to International Needs and see the boys' dorm complete in time for them to come back to school in February. Now, in addition to prayerfully considering what you can give in support of the boys' dorm, would you also hold up our partners in prayer? Please pray for Justus, their director, for wisdom and energy to lead in these unpredictable times. Please pray for the students to be able to return to class in February and stay safe. And pray especially for those taking national exams who have already lost many months of critical instruction. As we journey through our Christmas Compassion campaign, we hope you gain a glimpse into our partners and their amazing ministries. Our request is that you take some time this season to prayerfully consider how you can give to this amazing work. To donate, please visit our Compassion page online, call or drop by our office. We'd love to help you. Be sure to go to our webpage to see more photos, stories, and even a video from Justus filmed just a few weeks ago in front of the boys' dorm. These are available at crossroadschurch.ca/Christmas Compassion. Thank you so much for responding in support of our friends in Uganda. Thank you.